Hey guys, welcome back to my channel Automate Innovation. So today we're going to learn about access modifiers in Java. So let's just get started. So there are four main access modifiers in Java which we need to be aware of. First one is public, default, private, and protected. So why do we need access modifiers in Java? This is required because we would want to restrict the visibility and with respect to accessibility of certain instance variables or methods within the class or from accessing from outside the class to another class, right? So we would want to ensure that the security is not compromised. So we have different access modifiers stating that what can be accessed and what cannot be accessed. So let's look at the visibility levels. Public is the highest visibility. So if you're having a class, let's say within this basics package, like access modifiers, and if you have another class like class 3, this class 3 can access any, if it is basically inheriting, let's say class 3 is inheriting your access modifier. So it can access any public variable. It is not going to have any issue. So we'll look into that. So this is accessed across same as well as different packages. That is the meaning of public. So it's the highest visibility. Right. The next one is default. Default is within same class or by other class in same package. So if you're having another class within the same package inheriting your access modifiers class, then that can access the default instance variable if it's in the same package. Next one is private, within the same class only. So this cannot be inherited, neither it can be seen across by the classes of other within the same package. And the next one is protected, can be accessed within same or different packages, okay, by the subclass. So let's just understand this concept. So let's just have some instance variables now. So I've got four instance variable of different types here, and let's say void get a. This is, let's say, private. Return a. And we have got another method now, which is, let's say, protected, which will just display the details of the other variables, which is A. Then we'll be printing D. Right? So we are having these all different variables printed here. And now let's just go into, we are going to also have, okay, instead of returning, we can just directly do this out. Okay, so we have got two methods now. One is private and one is, so we have to make it void. So one is private method and one is protected method. So this access modifiers class is within this basics package. Okay, now if I have a class 3, another class in the another package, so let's say int a equal to 19. Void get a, we'll just keep it simple. And we'll just have, okay. So we'll just have public static void main in this method. Okay, so what we're going to do, guys, is that we are having two classes which are in different packages. So I'll make now that this class 3 is extending my access modifiers. Okay, so as well as the extents, it's in another package. So I have to import the package as well as the class which I want to access. I've imported that. So it says basics.accessModifiers. So how the concept of packages and classes goes is that you have to mention first import statement. What is the package name? Using the dot operator, which class you want to access, because there might be multiple classes in the same package. So I mentioned that. Okay, now create the object of this class. So if you don't know the basics of Java, you can refer to my previous tutorials. Now, if I use the object operator obj dot, it should show me whatever is accessible. So if you see from the other class access modifiers, it is able to access C, D instance variables and this details method. It is not able to access the private variables and methods. So F and get A is not accessible, but D and C and A should be accessible. Even this detail should be accessible. So let's look at that. If you see D, C, this details is accessible and even A is accessible, because A now is having class 3 also is having A, as well as your access modifiers is also having A. So in this case, it will basically show us the value of A of this particular class. Okay. And now, yeah, so let's just go ahead and run this program. So I'll just access this details method, and it is not able to access my private method and variable. Okay. Now there's another concept which I wanted to explain you all here. So in access modifiers, we have this thing. Okay. Instead of private, if I would have had this as, let's say, protected. Okay. So your void get A, if you see, it's showing an error here. That the reason is because it has got get A from access modifier. But however, you cannot have the get A again in your class 3 if your visibility is less than protected. You have to have either protected or public. It should be of same access modifier level or above. So we can make it as protected. It will not give the any error, and it shows a green symbol showing that it has overridden your access modifiers get A method. So it will basically invoke this get A method now of class 3 rather than that of access modifier. So let's look at that. If you see here, it's showing class 3 rather than of access modifiers. So let's access it and run this program. Yeah, it has printed the value of A as 19 instead of printing the value as 10. So that explains the concept of method overriding as well as the access modifiers. If you have any questions or comments, you can leave it out in the space. Hope you like this video. Please keep watching more. Thank you so much.